What's up, guys? Welcome to Wrench Capital Charts. Today, we're taking a look at SoFi stock, ticker symbol SOFI, on a variety of time frames in anticipation of the next trading day. Tuesday, May 14th. All right, guys, SoFi stock here today up 17 cents per share, plus 2.45% in regular trading hours. Let's take a look at this and pull out everything the market was willing to give us on this day. We got a big pop not long after off the open, and then kind of a slower, maybe half, two-third fade into the end of the day. We're going to look at the volume profile, which is kind of looking under the hood, see what we can find out. We'll look at the psychological levels. Big money's paying attention to them. We're going to need to as well. Implied volatility, the expected move for tomorrow, and finally, the directional bias out of the chain for tomorrow. So let's get started here, taking a look at that volume profile here on the five-minute chart. Listen, guys, by the way, if you're new here, SoFi is today's wild card stock. The wild card stock is the third video out each day. Hits at around 5:30 p.m. every single trading day. And that wild card stock each day is, of course, voted on by you guys in the comment section. So anyway, if you are new here, please subscribe to the channel and I will keep the videos coming daily. So let's peel back the onion and see if we can find anything out. Really, what we're looking for is directional bias that isn't necessarily so obvious simply by looking at the price action. And if we look under the hood, this is really interesting, guys, because we see a normal open bar and then we get a fade. We expect that on most days. But then what we get is we get increased volume, a big sample size on what is really mostly green bars. Now, don't get me wrong, we see some random fades in volume here, right? However, we're seeing very out of context size in terms of the amount of shares traded on each 5 minute bar, specifically on that move to the upside. And then as soon as that fade kind of begins right around here, we see volume tank off and get more contextual for what's expected kind of midday here on SoFi. Then into the close, you know, we get a little bit of pops here. Yeah, fine. And then into the close, we see a pretty normal, at least for SoFi, which is tends to be a little more choppy than other names, pretty normal volume, okay? But off the open there, it's pretty obvious that's a little bit of bullish bias there off the open on that upside move compared to the fade. Now, let's move on here to those psychological self-fulfilling prophecy levels here on SoFi, starting with the very simple 30-minute chart. Now, you guys can see here that we began the day, or at least pre-market, below both the 50 period and the 200 period. We opened, held the 50 period as support after reclaiming it in pre-market, which I like to see retests on that when the real volume comes in, held it as support, ripped upside through the 200 period, and we have yet to now make a retest. But listen, bulls, today was a favorable day for you guys on the 30-minute chart. Tomorrow, here's a few things I'd like to see. I'd like to see the 50 period make an upside move, probably end up over the 200 period, not for the sake of the crossover, but simply for the sake of it being a quicker moving average, getting up underneath the move that we had today, right? About, you know, 15, 20 cents or so. And listen, bulls, any retest of either of those moving averages, I want to see it hold as support. Now, bears, ideally, your goal tomorrow is to make today look like a mistake by getting back beneath both of those moving averages and holding beneath, claiming both of them as short-term resistance yet again. All right. Now, the four-hour chart, if we take a look, you guys can see, again, reclaimed the 50 period on the four-hour as well, rejected off the 200 period, and now we're hovering somewhere in between. Okay, but reclaiming the 50 is a big first step. We have been struggling to do that for a few weeks here now on SoFi. Bulls, any retest of that 50 period here on the 4-hour, I want to see that hold as support, but really, the goal is to reclaim that 200 period. Get above on high volume, retest, and bounce. Claiming that 200 period as short-term support, that would be a beautiful thing to see. Bears, any retest, or I'm sorry, any test, really, of that 200 period. Well, I suppose we did test it and reject today. So any retest of that 200 period, you want to see that treated the same way as we saw today, reject as resistance, but really the goal, if you're a bear, that's kind of like the safety net, right? The goal is to get back down beneath the 50 period and treat that again as resistance. But what's interesting is here on the 4-hour, the 50 period is right at $7 a share, which we know is a huge technical and psychological level on the daily chart, which is the most important chart by far. There's a lot going on here on the daily. Let's talk about that. Now, first of all, you can see we rejected very clean. You could almost argue that that 50-day moving average was really what it was looking at. I like to think that the market was looking at the 4-hour and the daily. But listen, we rejected hard off that 50-day moving average, the white line, here on SoFi today. On top of that, we also held $7 a share off the open. Okay, here's what I'm watching. We're in a very important channel right now between 7 and the 50-day moving average, bulls. Two things, really. Hold 7, as if your life depends on it, ideally, and get above the 50-day moving average as soon as possible. That would be wonderful. You can see that we haven't really spent any reasonable or meaningful time above the 50-day since early March. Getting back above, like, it's time, right? Bears, any retest of that 50-day, you want to see it reject as hard as possible, like we saw today. But really, the goal, bears, how do you discourage as many bulls as possible in the very short term? Get below $7 a share as soon as possible. Now, implied volatility, especially important if you trade options. You can see here, it's up a little bit here today, but still very low compared to the last 3 months. Okay, IV crush, if you're experiencing it, this is why. All right, now, as far as buying new options, the vega value that's priced into those right now, at least for this intended trade time frame, right, compared to the last few months, is going to be very low. So it's a lot of people would say it's a more favorable time to buy options. But that goes for both calls and puts, so you still have to have a directional bias. But as far as the volatility is concerned, being priced into those, it is low compared to the last few months. So keep that in mind. Now, expected move. The next expiration we have on SoFi is Friday. And the expected move by Friday compared to today's close, by Friday's close, right, compared to today's close, is plus or minus 36 cents a share. So what we can do here to get tomorrow's expected move is we can divide that by 4 trading days, but we have to add back about 50%. This is a little bit of guesswork, but we have to do what we can because we do not have the luxury of daily expirations on SoFi, right? And once we add back that 50% to make up for the fact that that initial calculation implies 4 green days in a row or 4 red days in a row, we get plus or minus about 13 or 14 cents a share here on SoFi by tomorrow's close compared to today's close. That's kind of the market's expected volatility, which is really important to understand, especially if you're trading options, what the market expects, so you can take a position against that if you disagree in either direction. Now you might be thinking, well, okay, that's good to know. What about directional bias? Let's look at volume. 311,000 contracts traded today, 252,000 calls, 59,000 puts. Heavy, very heavy call side bias on SoFi here today. And if we break, oh my goodness, if we break this down by short-term speculators, the 0 to 20 delta range, 87,000 calls, 12,000 puts. Listen, guys, the option traders are just one factor, and they can, of course, be wrong. Okay, the volume on SoFi is lower than the other blue chips we look at, so take it with a bit of a grain of salt, but that's what the traders are telling us here today. That's their bias as far as the volume is concerned. Now listen, hey, if you guys got value out of that video, you want me to continue to cover SoFi here in the future, I appreciate it if you just leave a like on the video, and then, listen, get out of here and enjoy your day. I appreciate it, and I'll see you in the next one.